Welcome to the channel of the Center for Study and Teaching at the Technical University of Munich. In the following introduction, first we introduce the new TUMonline application courses and explain how to use it. We show you, second, the detailed view of a course and explain, third, the basic structure of the new registration procedures. Finally, we, fourth, explain the now integrated functions for registered and bookmarked courses. At campus.tum.de, you can access the TUMonline homepage. Here you will find the login mask at the right side. Enter your TUM ID or your email address as well as your password here to access your personal area via the login button. Before you enter your personal area, you will see current information about your account or notes about your studies on this page. By clicking on Continue, you will get to your personal overview page. In the All Applications area, you will find the application Courses in the category Studies and Courses. You can open it by clicking on the corresponding tile. The application displays all published courses at TUM in the selected semester. In addition, a compact overview of your registrations and bookmarks of courses is integrated in the two further tabs My Courses and My Bookmark Courses. To quickly display the courses that are relevant to you, you can apply several filters. At the top left under Term, select the semester for which you want to display the courses. Immediately next to it, you can select your degree program under Curriculum so that only the courses that are already assigned to your degree program are displayed. Under Organization, you can select an organization if you wish to display only the courses offered by a particular faculty, for example. This can be useful if the program of study is not completely modeled and therefore not all relevant courses have been assigned to the curriculum. When selecting a degree program, it will generally make sense to leave the default section Technische Universität München. An additional restriction to one faculty could be helpful, for example, if the courses offered in your degree program are made up of two different faculties. In addition, the quick filter allows you to filter the list of courses according to specific criteria, for example, a keyword in the title or a lecturer. Further filters can be found under the corresponding button. Here you can filter, among other things, according to the language of instruction or the type of course or the place, period or day of the week on which it takes place. By default, the courses are displayed in ascending alphabetic order. You can, however, use the corresponding button to select a different sort order, by title, number or type of course, in ascending or descending order. If you want to register for a course from this list, click on Course Registration in the line of the corresponding course. This will take you to the registration procedure, which we will look at in the next but one step. If you first like to find out more about a course, click on the title or the arrow key at the end of the entry to get to the detailed view. Under Overview, you will find a summary of the most important facts, such as the lecturers and which organization is in charge of the course, what type of course it is, or how many semester hours per week it comprises. Under Description, the contents, requirements, objectives, as well as additional information, for example, regarding the recommended literature, are listed. Under Dates and Groups, you will find the dates of the course, possibly divided into groups as well as the total time period in which it is held. Using the buttons in the section header, you can switch between the summarized schedule view and a detailed list of individual dates. Under Status within Curriculum, you can see the modules and study programs to which the course is assigned and the position in the respective curriculum. By clicking on the study plan version number, you will be forwarded to the study plan so that you can view it in detail. Finally, under Equivalent Courses, you can see whether this course or an equivalent course will be offered again in the same semester or in which semesters it has taken place so far. If you now want to register for the selected event, click on Course Registration on the left-hand side of the page, you will then be redirected to the registration procedure from here. The most important information in advance. With the new registration procedure, registration, distribution and allocation are asynchronous, so that the time of registration no longer plays a role. In the case of distribution, the rules of the procedure apply first. If it is possible to choose from several groups in a procedure, you can also prioritize your requests. These preferences are evaluated according to the rules of the procedure. Registration no longer takes place directly for individual groups of courses, but for a procedure. Thus, several groups can be encapsulated in a procedure in order to allocate fixed places in different courses in dependence on each other, so that as many interested students as possible are offered at least one place and one student is not offered several places and others none. In the header of the registration page, you will see the most important information summarized once again, such as the registration period, the criteria for ranking in the procedure, instructions on how to request documents and, if applicable, details on the allocation. If you are enrolled in more than one degree program, you can select the degree program you wish to enroll in the procedure above. If it was defined in the procedure that each student must be given a place in each assigned group, no further selection has to be made, and you can enter your place request with a click at the bottom right. If it was defined in the procedure that each student can choose from the assigned groups, select the desired group or groups. You can then edit your preference for each group and finally enter your place request. Your place request is now saved. Within the registration period, you can edit your place request and your preferences. What happens next? If there are no participant restrictions, either in the registration procedure or in the assigned course groups, the supervisor of the procedure can activate a continuous fixed place allocation. In this way, new registrations are processed by a background process approximately every 5 minutes and the maximum number of possible fixed places in the procedure is allocated. In the case of courses without participant restrictions, you will generally be given a fixed place a little later. Distribution will usually take place after the registration period. In this case, the applications are distributed among the available places according to the ranking criteria of the procedure and the students' preferences. If necessary, the supervisors of the registration procedure can also process the registrations, for example, in order to keep the groups as small as possible, or to distribute the interested parties as evenly as possible, or to re-register interested parties in groups which do not come about. Subsequently, a fixed place can be allocated to the distributed registrations. In the case of courses with restricted attendance, you will therefore generally only be given a fixed place after the registration period. You will be informed automatically by email of any changes to your registration that are relevant to you. For example, if a fixed place is retained or if you change your registration to another group. However, you will not be able to register for all courses via the TUMonline application. Some courses are registered in the faculty's own systems, for example, matching. In such cases, your faculty and TUMonline will provide you with the relevant information and the detailed view of a course if the button View Registration Details is displayed instead of the button Course Registration, respectively. To find out about other courses or to register for them, return to the list of courses. As soon as you have registered for one or more courses, they will appear in your personal overview under the tab My Courses. You can also filter them by semester and display them sorted by title, number or type. Under the tab My Bookmarked Courses, you will find the courses that you have marked by clicking on the star icon next to their title. You can now adjust the notification setting by clicking on the gear wheel icon in the list of the pre-booked courses. By the way, in the settings of the calendar application, you can choose whether you only want to have the appointments displayed if you have a fixed place in the course, or whether you want to have the appointments for all registrations displayed. You can also choose whether or not you want to display the dates of bookmarked course groups. Further information about TUMonline can be found in the TUM Wiki system at wiki.tum.de or on the YouTube channel of TUM Student Info. In case of technical problems, please contact TUM IT support under it-support@tum.de. Thank you very much for your attention. Good luck and much success from the Center for Study and Teaching at the Technical University of Munich.